Welcome back, everyone, to the game show Global Esports Cup. It is Dignitas against Envious in Group A, joined by BX3 and Dendity. The two teams, Dendity and BX3, had to forfeit the first two matches yesterday because of some other obligations. So Dignitas and Envious moved right on to the upper bracket final in Group A. We will see BX3 and Dendity later on today at 10 o'clock. I thank you guys for tuning in. I hope the first map was entertaining. I sure thought that it was. And Dignitas and Envious facing off on Mirage. It is the map pick of the Frenchman. We already saw Mirage and Train in the last best of three. Both of the teams played against each other, and it ended 2-1 in favor of the Frenchmen. So you can tell that Dignitas is able to get a map off of Envy. The question is if they will be able to pick Mirage off of them. The terrorists will head over to the B bombsite to get some momentum going over there, but they quickly reconsider. They just want to show off some footsteps over there, and now they are back in mid with three players, basically. NBK just holding defensively and happy on the A bombsite, being the lurker, everyone knows. The CT is with some good mid control, and Config is going for that peak. He's going for the all-in peak over here on the B apartments. That could be the stick between the legs of the terrorist. The bomb is still in terrorist spawn. Oh, Config doesn't pick up anyone. Now the full rotation is headed over to the B bombsite. MSL is still in underpass, and the terrorists are slowing down again. So, change of plans for Envy. They don't want to capitalize on the first frag. They want to pull their players together and make it happen on A. Apex is already there, taking point. MSL catches them. He spots everyone. He can call it out for his teammates. But the bomb still hasn't been spotted, and that's a key thing to see for the CTs. Envy pushing in with Happy from the balcony. Kenny S chimes in with his own kill, and as soon as that, the pistol round is almost over. Terrorists don't even lose more than four players. I think you all know what I wanted to say, but I jinxed it in the middle of the sentence. There it goes, another one. Tenski, if he keeps going like that, he could even pick up the ace. But now NBK and KNES are a little bit too scared. They are running away, letting the bomb explode, and avoiding feeding Tenski with some more money and some more confidence. Heads up play by Tenski. Just overall great performance by him in this first round. Even though he was left alone, he put down his foot. He didn't make it flawless for Envy. You know, those small things, they are in your head and they're in your opponent's head. If they win the pistol round flawlessly after turning the game on Train upside down, I think the Frenchman would be very happy. But with Dignitas picking up those three frags, saving the Diffuse Kid, they actually have enough money for a Famous, and they go all in into this round. Let's see where the Famous is positioned at. It's in middle, the most versatile position on the map. And maybe one day he could put up the most resistance. NBK definitely was surprised, but the MP7 goes to work. Apex with the refrag. The CTs are going to be unable for now to retrieve the weapon. It's been dropped in the middle of the window. Oh, Rubino gets his hands over there like a thief. He's got his long fingers sneaking into window, picking it up. Tenski is caught on the other side of the window, but that is supposed to be the case for him. He was supposed to surprise the terrorist on the roof. Apex, with the patience of an experienced hunter, he's waiting for the next CT to show up. It was Tenski who goes down. The terrorist in full force on the A bombsite. Okiebi with his headshot off the deagle onto Happy. Drawing it back a little bit. He's not going down. He refuses to go down. Kyo and Kenny finally chime in with the kills, leaving Config alone, and CT spawn with a P250 in his hands. It's not going to make that big of a difference if he gets a few frags here. But again, we are back to the confidence. It might have an impact on the confidence of his own team. If he picks up another kill, you know, there's some slight cheering going on, even though they lost the first few rounds. It's like a, yeah, you got the kill. Or, yeah, you try to ninja defuse. Sometimes you have to be positive, you know? You have to think and exaggerate everything you see and feel in a positive way, not in a negative. The Danes have nothing to exaggerate. They have no money, no equipment, no pistols, no nades, and probably no chance either. Apex is putting the first one down already from his home position. He's going to work on the second and now runs into some trouble. But look at how long the CTs were actually shooting at him and how low the amount of damage it was. Apex with a terrific kill, Envious with a 3-0. So the Danes with the first buy round. We still see a MAC-10 for Kiyoshima. He wants to get some more money in the bank, and he's got a Tech-9 to back it up with. Basically designed to be the perfect faker on the B-bomb side, having a lot of nades. And he can, if he picks up a frag over there, he can exchange his weak weapon for a rifle. He can also just step around a little bit and pretend to be more than only one guy over there. The friends of France will head over into middle. Apex is getting ready for the flash. Flashing himself and his teammates in. The CTs had two players over there. One on B short. He's a little bit too slow to back away. Tensky goes down. So is MSL to NBK. Great opening frags by NVS. And another follows right in the tracks. Combined with Happy. It's a 5v1 already. It seems almost impossible for Dignitas to hold on to those pushes. Even though we saw those forced buy rounds, those save rounds in the first few, in the past two rounds, let's say like that. I think there is a special feel to a game. You know, when you've watched game after game, you kind of feel that something is falling into place for a certain team, or something is just not working out for the other team. And in my opinion, it looks impeccable. The game that Envious is playing at the moment, it looks, it makes me feel that they won't have too many problems anymore in their terrorist side. Not only because they won the first rifle and now they're facing off against another save round, but also the overall behavior. You know, there are no leaks, there are no clutches so far, they didn't have to struggle, they were working together. Look at that push. They just completely ignore they are being fired at, and they just push into the bomb site. Everyone's very confident, getting the frags, getting the picks, working together. Apex is feeling amazing, picking up double kill here and there and everywhere, basically. And in the end, they don't let the CTs escape either. On the other side, the CTs are really struggling to get any frags, obviously. You have 005 on Config, who was one of the main performers in the first map. On the other side, we have 10-1 for Apex. Another weapon round. This time, it is MSL with the orb. And we have seen that he can have an impact with that weapon on train. Did get quite a few very important frags on the terrace and on the CT side. So he's not scared away from the orb, or from picking up the orb on the terrorist side either. Now, good Molotov is pushing the terrorist away from A main. Was placed behind the smoke, so the flames spread even further. And the T's are fed up with that. They are going for a small rotation, but the bomb stays at A. So it's going to go down to another train-like fake game by Envious. They have Kiyoshima on the B-bomb site. He's poking there. He's not necessarily trying to gain too much ground or anything. Now he's even in the underpass, trying to get the better of MSL in a second. MSL is still in connector. Let's watch out. Oh, Rubino with the push into MBK, drops the bomb. He's even able to secure it a little bit better with a flash. Tries to maintain position and control, but Happy puts him down. In the meantime, Kiabai disposes of of Apex. Makes it a 3v3 again. Now shifts it into the mana favor for his teammates. Look at that. 1 HP. Kenny has lobs the nade right on top of his head. Makes it a 2v2 again. It's back and forth in this round. Dignitas knows how important it is. They are on the CT side of Mirage. It is supposedly the better side. Now Config trading 1 for 1. Happy on 34 HP. This could be the case for Config. He will clutch it for Dignitas. Picks up the orb as well before defusing the bomb. And even though he was on 0-0-5, those two kills in the 2v1 won the round for Dignitas, and they are finally on the board on the second map. It was about time, though. The Danes probably wouldn't have been able to sustain, you know, mentally sustain any more losses in this on this map. If it's 6 or 7-0 on Mirage and you're facing the terrorists, they have so much room to work with. They can go for the foolish of the foolish pushes. One of them might have been NBK at the moment, pushing for apartments, but they want to keep Rubino from doing it again. So that was the right move to make for NVS. They need that map control. Now that MBK went down, Apex feels the moment is right to make a smoke and surprise somebody. He does pick up the headshot, but he didn't spot Kiabi, who is very sneaky. Like a ninja, pops up from dark, picks up the double kill, makes it a 4v2. Kenny S and Happy make that minus Happy. Only Kenny S standing for the terrorists, who seem to have lost that edge that I was speaking of earlier when they won the first 4 rounds. That aura, you know, that just confidence, they were illuminated with it. I think that NVS might have lost some of it due to the fact of the loss in the clutch situation. Oh, there goes Kenny S, though. He's still not out of this round. 34 seconds on the clock. Oh, he's getting that shot with the Tech 9 onto Rubino, making it a 1v2. The CTs are still quite far away, but at least they are together. They can help and hold each other's hands. Well, maybe they will hold them in grave as well. Kenny is on the prowl. He didn't spot Config. And the CT is getting out on top of that exchange. Even though Kenny was able to pull the trigger, he missed his shot. And Dignitas have the second round on the board. It's about time for the Danes to get a grip on the game. The terrorists still have a lot of money to work with. 7k on two guys, 1.3 and 2.2 for Happy and NBK. Even if they don't get the bomb plant, they can drop for each other. They can squeeze out something that you can call a buy, especially on the terrorist side. So the Frenchman should be set for this and the next round. But the CTs are getting back on track. Now Kiyu and MBK combine to shift it away from the CTs, even though Tensky got that cheeky first frag. NVS is doing a good job of keeping it level, at least. MBK and Kiyu down to 16 and 22 HP. So naturally, they're facing off with the B-bombsite. They figure in a 3v4, the B-bombsite should only be defended by maybe one. Could maybe call it 1.5 men. But Config gets a double kill and definitely puts on his foot and says, okay, you came so far, but that's all you can get. I'm here, and now I will call in for my teammates to rotate and help me even further. But the same happened to the terrorists. Look at Happy sneaking into CT spawn already. Kenny is just drawing the bomb in from terrorist spawn. Happy picked up that very, very important frag in this round. Rubino going down. Rubino being one of the main performers for Dignitas. And on top of that, he was in the most important position to cover in CT spawn. Now the bomb will be planted. Kiabai will find out that it's not on B. And he will go for it. He will try to clutch this round, just like Config did before. Good Molotov drawing Kenny's out. He has heard him as well. Just a brief fire exchange. Didn't result in any kills so far, but obviously Kiabi knows that there is a terrorist behind the big boxes. He's turning around, twitching his hand, and Happy is twitching his as well. NVS make it 6-2 with a round that started off well, with a 1-4-2 trade in favor of the terrorists. And even though Config stopped the B push, it resulted into a very bad situation for the CTs, because the terrorists were pushed back towards A, where no CT was at all, because all the CTs were going for the rotation already. And that made it even easier for NVS to win the round in the end. It sounds kind of weird to say that a double kill by one of the defenders made it a better round for the attackers, but the mid-round call made it go down like that. So the CTs with a save, Kirby picked up a brief frag with his Famous, but after that he was killed, so the terrorist up in a 4v2. Rubin O still getting that kill onto Apex, picking up the AK as well, a way more dangerous weapon, but Kiyo shows how this and why this weapon is so dangerous. The accuracy is not to underestimate, and obviously the damage is quite big. Config with the Deagle, the same goes for that weapon. And the three terrorists are potential one kills if he hits the head, obviously. Two of them could be one kills if he gets close enough or hits the right spot. He has spotted Kiyo, who is on the prowl for the kill. Quick reaction, but not enough. Kiyo is quicker. 7-2 in favor of NVS. It looks like a sturdy performance on Mirage. The feeling I had at the first few rounds didn't fool me. It was the right feeling to have when you see NVS getting those entry frags and then working perfectly with the information they get, with the control they get as well. 12 and 11 for Apex and Kenny S. Ah, great shot by Kenny again. Good nade as well into window, even though KRB got that kill. The terrorists are playing it a little more loose, you know, a little less disciplined, just a little more relaxed, you know. They knew it would be a weak round for Dignitas, so why not go in to middle and just figure everything out on the go. Good nade onto Kiabi. Directed from the wall. Good spray by him, though, making it hard for Apex to go for the frag. Oh, what a shot by Kiabi! Great, great performance. But it's not going to change the outcome of the round, and that's the saddest thing to see. If somebody like Kiabi is pulling off shots like that and they are not going to have an impact in the round, it's heartbreaking for me. And I think it's heartbreaking for the Danish fans in the channel too. With a CT-sided bias on Mirage, Dignitas should focus on what NVS did on train. NVS lost the first half 8-7 against Dignitas on train, and NVS was on the CT side. Another biased map, and they turned it around too. So the Danes need to focus on every single round. They have to say, okay, we didn't win the last one, but this one we are going to win. And it looks not too good for them though. Apex with another double kill. He's really racking it up today. And that was just dirty refragging by the terrorists. Now Dignitas is stepping it up again, cleaning out the A bombsite. Config wants to see if there is any more left over there so he can make a call on that information. But with 1 minute on the clock, that's quite hard to tell for the CTs where the bomb is at. And as you can see, the bomb has been planted at A. NBK is so low on HP, he just has to draw fire once and then stay behind that wall. For God's sake, don't peek out anymore. And he will spot that player. He will actually go for the kill and does pick it up as well. Config with another chance to clutch a 1v2. Gets gets rid of NBKS first, and KennyS has the orb, not the best weapon to hold on, but he gets the knife kill onto Config. Oh my god, KennyS, cheeky as he is, 9-2 in favor of Envious. 7 rounds between them and the CTs, denying the 2v1 clutch on the youngster in the worst possible way with the knife. Oh, that is definitely a downfall for Dignitas. Because when I talk about motivation, about how you focus on games, how it's a mental game, you know, it's a momentum-based game as well. So many different factors, and most of them in your brain, obviously. That 2v1 could have kickstarted Dignitas' comeback. Could have been the lion's roar to get everyone back into the game and drag them along maybe for one more round with a good performance. Then everyone realizes, oh, we still have something to fight for. But since Kenny has got the knife kill, that kind of got turned into the other team's favor, into Envious's favor, and made it so good for them. You know, they can cheer, they can laugh a little bit about that moment, and then they can settle back and go, okay, guys, let's focus again. Then we will make it 13-2. Definitely possible. Dignitas is a little bit deflated, out of ideas. They have to make something up, but they seem to be unable to do so. MSL has been in that same position in a few previous rounds already. The same goes for Tenski, who is in underpass or on top of it. So they are sharing the same ideas, they are sharing the same positions like they did in the previous rounds. That makes it really easy for a team like NVS to figure them out and crack them open. Like the shell of a seashell. Yes. Dignitas with the 3 frags, though sometimes only fragging can help you out, and they will make it a 3v2. Kenny S and Happy still waiting. Kenny S is spotted. Rubino puts a bullet to his side, taking him down to 43 HP. Not enough for the frag, though. That gives some information to the CTs and denies the terrorist full control of the area. Kenyas is hunting down that frag, and he's going all in on that frag. He just wants to get rid of Rubino. Now he's getting spotted off guard, and Dignitas will get their 3rd round on the board thanks to some heads-up team play, some good coordination as well. Rubino calling out that, you know, I have to give up middle. It's lost. I've been tagged by the orb. It's most likely an A execution. Well, if you can call a 2vx situation an execution. So I have to retreat to CT spawn to stay safe. Somebody take the door for me. And that's that was the case for the CTs. They turned around quite well. Still enough money in the bank for the terrorists, though. And they will head to the A bomb site to get some initial control. Getting the 2 frags is Kiyoshima. And Envy is not letting loose on that one. It's like a shark, you know, if he bit your leg, he's dragging you down to the ground of the sea sometimes. If you're lucky, he bites it off and you can swim away. But Envious is definitely not in for some legs. They want to get the whole package. Happy with the spray down from Connect, and it's left completely open. You can never leave that open. Tenski with the frag then, and another trade resolves in a 1v3 situation. Config is left alone, and he's caught in the crossfire already. Envy make it 11-3. The Frenchmen are pulling away with a massive scoreline on the terrorist side. Apex with an epic performance as well. 20-9 in less than 15 rounds. Joined by his teammates, of course, who support him quite well. Look at that again. The terrorists will peek together into middle. They will pick up that frag. Last round of this first half on the second map, by the way. The first one went to Envious 16-13 after a good comeback. They were down 8-7 when they were started. They started on the CT side on train. just saying. But now they are starting on the terrorist side on Mirage, and they are not letting any or leaving any questions unanswered, even though they lose another man there to Config! Woo! What is he doing there? Double kill with the Deagle, making it a 1v1 is Rubino with the refrag onto Kenny, yes. And maybe I have spoken too soon. Dignitas is still not... You know, sometimes the longer the game goes on, the more fierce the competition gets, and the more the team that's actually down wants to win. You know, at first it's 6-0, you think, okay, we can come back. But when it's 11-3, it's like, oh, we need this round. Come on, boys. Rubino is shooting him down, making it 4-11. Dignitas with the clutch by Rubino. Great effort by him. Envious not able to make it as decisive as it could be. But, you know, this should tell you the story already. Not too much impact in the rounds by the CTs. The terrorists brought quite a few players into every single round. They weren't struggling at all. Look at that. The blue graph is now connected to Envious. So the blue graph is the terrorist equipment value, while the orange graph is connected to those blue ones and connected to Kiabai and company. So you can see the terrorists didn't have to save or force buy a single round in the first half. And economy is a big game, is a big part of the game as well. It's a game in itself. And that's just Apex taking off like a rocket. There is almost no round that he didn't get a frag, except for the fifth round where he ended up... Oh! The seventh, he ended up empty-handed as well. But apart from that, he picked up so many kills. 2 in the first, 3 in the second, 3 in the third. Yes, 2 in the fourth, and so on and so forth. So multiple multi-kill rounds by Apex. And that is going to break your neck on the CT side, obviously. Now it's Envious on the CT side. They are facing off with that... Great B bombsite push by Dignitas. We're not wasting any time or any equipment. Getting the two frags already, making it a 3v4. Envious on the rotation. Kenyas didn't spot anyone. Now he spotted somebody. Entangled in the firefight. Config surface by. Says, okay, thank you, Kiabi. Thanks for making him go down to low HP. Rubino gets some control into kitchen, and it's left to Apex. Oh, 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 okay, Apex, he's Santa, look at him, delivering the package to the heads of the terrorist. MSL is alone with the Glock in apartments, perfect position for him, he's got eyes on the bomb, he just needs to play it patiently. Apex is exposed, and now it's going down the wire. MSL is still peeking, he shouldn't do that though. Now it is going to be saved, but Apex with the triple kill of hell, that was just popping balloons. You know, those games when you're at that huge fair and they have those balloons and you can shoot darts at them. Apex had a dart machine gun and he was popping balloons all over the place. The Frenchman definitely did make Dignitas catch their breath for a second there. Now we have a small pause out of no apparent reason. At least nobody dropped or has ping problems. Okay, there he goes. Config, big shout out to you for letting us know. And Kiabi is ready again. Seems like maybe, you know, even though they are pros, they are living with people, sometimes girlfriends, sometimes parents, sometimes siblings. And when somebody else starts downloading something because you forgot that you have a big online game, it's obviously a huge bummer for you. So sometimes you have to interact with your fellow human beings to keep them from... Okay, Apex just spinning in circles. From, you know, just to keep them from impacting your hobby. So the CTs go for the cheeky stack at the B bomb site didn't work out. NBK is now the last line of defense on the A bomb site, and he's decided to go for some information and some map control instead of you know, trying to desperately get a kill against five terrorists. Now Apex is going to be the linchpin of this attack, of this retake. He's coming in from CT spawn with MBK just holding back. Together with Happy, he will push in from the back while his CT team members are trying to divert the attention away from A main. That Apex gets that kill onto Kierby. The CTs are running out of time though, they have to hurry up a little bit. Happy going through apartments, the CTs already pull out, but there might be a few extra frags up for grabs for them. Not necessarily. MBK picks up the double though, and that is making it as expensive as the CTs tried to make it. The three kills definitely paid off for them, or could pay off for them in the later stages of this map. Keep in mind that NVS managed to win the first map. The map pick of Dignitas was Train. It started off very well for the Danes, but even though they achieved an 8-7 scoreline on the terrorist side, Envious came back and the Danes fell flat 16-13 on Train in favor of the Frenchmen. $200,000 at stake in the league, by the way. We have four groups in the European group stage number 2. The two teams that are in the same group as Envious and Dignitas are Dendidi from Sweden and BX3 from Norway. Promising lineups, maybe not there yet, but Dendidi could pull an upset against Dignitas, that's for sure. They might even upset Envious if they had to, if they will go there, though, because BX3 is not to underestimate either. I will walk you through the details of the second best of three later on today. Obviously, we still have to wait a little longer. Actually, it's Elegon and not Dendidi, those Swedish mixed teams. You could call them the same. Elegon is replacing Dendidi because of some trouble with some other tournaments. They couldn't participate anymore. But we figured, why not get another Swedish team to replace a Swedish team? So at 10 o'clock, we will start with BX3 and Elegon. For now, we are just waiting for Kierby to come back to the server and relieve us from the pause. Ja, viele Grüße an unsere österreichischen Freunde draußen da. Okay. Ich bin halt oben in Berlin gerade. Sorry for the German guys and girls. I just had to greet my fellow, well, Germanophones. Let's call it Germanophones, because they speak German, but not really German. They speak a different accent of German, which sounds quite cool in my opinion. So yeah, I'm just spending my time interacting with the chat, something that you guys love a lot, and I do too. So somebody has brought some microphone issue to my attention that I'm making funny noises. I don't hear them myself, and you know, it's we have huge audio mixes, a lot of money has been spent, no expenses have been shied away from, so I'm sitting in a loop, so I speak into the microphone. The audio mixer is giving that back to my headphones, and then at the same time pushing it out to the output, and then it gets mixed in with the game sounds and my PC sounds. It's kind of complicated. I've never really understood what is going on over there. Thanks, Martin G. Vlad. Oh, Somebody is starting to moderate too. Who is that? Who is the vigilante that starts moderating the channel without any interaction with me? I really like that. So obviously I can't read all the messages, otherwise it will be busy until tomorrow. But no, I'm not Austrian, by the way, Jeffrey Giongini. But I'm not too far away from the Austrian border. I was born and raised near Munich. So fellow South Germans and fellow South inhabitants of Austria and South Germany, I think we are brothers in arms, you know. We want to get rid of Germany, you want to get rid of Austria. We could host a new kingdom, you know, the kingdom of gaming, maybe. Illusion BR, I think that's Brazil. Is that Brazil? Brazil? I always mispronounce names and country names. That's one of my big feats because I'm not a... not born in England. You demanded a kiss, so there you go. Yeah, big shout out to the other vigilante moderator that started banning. And yeah, we successfully tried or avoided getting, well, I kind of botched it, so this moment definitely was awkward now. But I wanted to be proud of myself for not making this pause awkward. I will give you my Twitter link in a sec. Let's focus on this anti-eco execution by Dignitas. It's a key round. If they lose this one, it could break them completely, scatter the pieces across the world and into the seven seas, possibly. They will manage to get the bomb landed, but with one casualty already. Oh, config like a sentinel, like a turret. Left and right, everyone goes down, but Kenyas fights back with his 5-7 from CT spawn. Rubino is down to 4 HP and Tensky is hiding away. If the terrorists played correctly, this should be a sure thing for them. They don't need to peek until they find out that Kenyas is defusing. Now that Kenyas managed to make it a 1v1, he could go for it, but he's running out of time. There is no... Yeah, there is no chance for him anymore. Dignitas will close the gap. Make it 7-11 with the first rifle round. Terrorists win. Oh, that caps lock. Wow. So caps lock. Still caps lock. Okay. So even though I really love interacting with you guys out there, I have to focus on the game to give everyone a pleasant experience. So I will stop answering questions in chat now. Envious with a 4-round lead and another rifle round coming up for them. While Dignitas is, you know, reaching for the holy grail of control of this game. Oh, Kenny, yes! What did he do to his rifles? I mean, that's just insane. I obviously have to cast a lot of different games, and I didn't have the pleasure to cast too many Envious games, but Kenyas is on fire with this rifling. Happy is not too bad either there. Rubino and Config have the bomb ticking in their favor, and Happy is, well, he's caught in a crossfire already. The terrorists should just wait again. They will wait, they will even flash each other in, and Rubino picking up a very impactful triple kill in this round. The CTs need to save. They will have enough money for an AWP in the upcoming round, but not enough for this one. So we will possibly see a 9-11. The gap is getting closer and closer. Envy could change this round though. They have armor a few deagles. They have dangerous weapons. They have dangerous positions. That's maybe the more important part of this round, that the CT's positions are quite dangerous. Not if the terrorists play it correctly, and that's what Dignitas is doing. And that's something that I criticize on a lot of tier 2 teams, that in those moments, when, you know, when the game is on the edge, you can tilt it into your own favor. You have an anti-eco round ahead of you. That young players, or young teams, sometimes lean a little bit too far back into their seats and they fall over, they lose that supposedly easy round and they get crushed by their opponents because their opponents won because of some of those stacks, for example, or some cheeky deagle headshots. I think one of the more important parts of the game is not only winning rounds, but winning the right rounds. And that's what you have to focus on. If you manage to screw your opponent's money, please do a good job of crushing him when he's saving. Otherwise, this could be this could be your own downfall. Now Dignitas is not wasting any time on the B execution. A little hasty, that move. They drop the bomb down below, and Happy is in a cheeky position. Picks up a double before being traded by Config. Once again, it's the youngster who draws it back to a 2v2. Already clutched a 1v2, but this time around he's eliminated. Tenski with 38 HP, struggling for any control. And Apex is already close by, tipping his shoulder saying, "You're out." And we have the round in our bag. Envious with a 12-9. Three rounds between them and the terrorists. And Dignitas is struggling with their finances. The Frenchmen are not giving this up. They are on the CT side. They know they are supposed to take control. And they are so close of winning the series. The best of three that determines the first qualification, the first qualified team for the playoffs in Group Stage 2. Oh, Apex with a double kill. And his teammates covered everything very, very thoroughly. Dignitas is losing patience, I believe. That very quick B play, you know, you can catch your opponent off guard, but more often than not, you're the ones caught off guard by some double stack by the CTs or some quick rotations. And the quick play on A is not necessarily different either. So maybe they're running out of ideas. There are so many different factors, you know, maybe Kiabi is just not feeling it anymore after the small break. Or maybe they just wanted to catch their breath for a few seconds. They definitely open up this round in their own favor with the kill onto NBK. They planned the bomb as well. They capture the rifle. The CT take already good packs by MSL. Not living up, not only living up to the expectations with the AWP, but also with the rifle, making it a 2v3. Config is going for a wide rotation. Look at that. His teammates need to hold on just a few more moments until he's there to help them out. And they, I think Happy has heard him. He's got an A prepared for that. Good kill by Config with the AWP. Now it's Hiroshima struggling for the frags. Not going to get it. Config with the double of the AWP. Dignitas win the eco round. That is what I talked about before. The game was about to shift around. And that's a sign that it happens to human beings overall. Envious has the game in the palm of their hands. You know, they can make it 14-9. A very comfortable lead on the CT side. But they think everything is set in stone already. They lean back a little too much. They get caught off guard on the B-bomb side. And suddenly, they lose the round due to some good rifle work by MSL and some good scoping by Config. So Dignitas is back on track. Maybe still not in the driving seat, but they are reaching over there, trying to push Envious out of the door on the other side of the car. But the Frenchmen are experienced drivers. They're not easy to be pushed out of that seat. Dignitas is calming down again, going for a slow approach. Yeah, the original in P positions, both of them. Now one of them goes down. Now it's Config flying on B bombs, but Kenny, yes, partially through the smoke. Another one goes down to him, leaving Kensky alone, and he's being backstabbed by Happy. Dignitas slowed down. They wanted to play it more methodically. But Envious had everything covered. No holes in their defense, and everyone is hitting his shots as well. That's something that sometimes you forget if the in-game leader makes the right calls, but you just don't hit anything. It's a huge problem for your team and for yourself as well. And yes, with the first pick, Rubin although steps it up, he knows that it's his moment. He needs to take the game and he needs to help his teammates out. 1v2 though in favor of the CTs. Config with the 1v1 equalizer. NBK is coming in from the connect area, and even though he's flashed, he finishes the frag onto Config. 15-10, 5 match points for Envious in the best of 3 series, with 30 frags for Apex already in just 25 rounds. 27 for Kenny, yes. Doesn't have to hide away either, especially with only 10 deaths. On the other side, we have 20 and 21 for Rubino and Config. Now Envious with a chance against the weak bye-bye the terrorists, and it looks like a clean sweep. Not necessarily too clean. NBK went down. Tensky is still fighting for his life, but he's pushed by everyone. 16-10 in favor of Envious. Great performance by Apex and Kenny S. And I think you guys out there for tuning in. We will be back with another best of 3 series at 10 o'clock. So that's roughly in 2 hours, you know, plus minus the 30-minute delay that we experience sometimes. So yeah. That was a great game by Envious, showing that they, even though they started off slowly at on train, they showed us, and they showed myself, they showed you guys out there, that they maybe put everything behind them. The not qualification for SLI series, and some not so good results in the past few months. Not months, but you know, past, yeah, month. Two months, and Apex showing that he is back on track. I hope that he will stay consistent this year around. I'm a huge Apex fan. He's a great guy, and he's also a great player, so I would really be pleased to see him perform as well as he did today. So many double kills, so many triple kills, just insane play by him. The same goes for Kenny S, obviously, and I don't want to forget about Dignitas' players, Rubino, Config, Kirby. All of them performed very, very well. And I think that Dignitas can work with that result. You know, they don't need to be upset. They don't need to be mad. Maybe work on train a little more. So if you win 8-7 on the terrorist side, you should win the map, in my opinion. But facing against Envious is always a very hard task. So I don't want to take away anything from Dignitas. Good luck to both teams in the future. We will see more of them. Possibly tomorrow, at least more of Dignitas. Envious has qualified already. They won their map yesterday against Dendidi, who then decided to drop out of the tournament and be replaced by Allegan. So Envious with 2 wins, obviously through to the next round. I think you guys out there, you can follow me on Twitter. It's DabooTV. I will give you the link in a moment. And yeah, I hope we will see each other later on for the second best of 3 series of the Game Show Global Esports Cup, brought to you by Game Show and Azubu, and obviously partnered with CSGO Lounge and eBattle. Thank you guys out there. It's been a great first cast in this year, just 7 days in, and I'm already back on track. I hope you will stay with me throughout the year. It's gonna be really cool.